Hello everyone, my name is Miranda All and I'm a developer advocate here at Timescale. Thank you so much for joining us and we are really excited to have you as we announce and demo the new functionality available in TimescaleDB 2.5. Get pumped because we have some awesome news for you today. Now, some of you may have heard already, but today we are actually going to be releasing support for continuous aggregates within a multi-node environment. Yeah. This is something that many of you have been asking for a long time, so we are really excited to offer you this new functionality. Now, before I get into a demo, I would like to recap on continuous aggregates and multi-node. Many of you have likely been using continuous aggregates for quite some time, but for those of you who are not familiar with them, you can think of them as similar to Postgres materialized views, but with lots of extra functionality. Continuous aggregates actually allow you to access our retention and refresh policies. With these policies, you can actually keep your aggregated data up to date automatically with your real-time raw data. And not only that, you can actually manipulate what time periods you would like to keep updated so that you can remove historical raw data without affecting your aggregated data. Yeah, pretty cool, right? That was a very quick explanation of continuous aggregates. So if you are interested in learning more about continuous aggregates, definitely check out the links that I have below, as they have lots of additional content and information on how to get started with continuous aggregates. Now, you can imagine, or you know firsthand, how useful continuous aggregates can be. And previously, we did not allow you to use them in a multi-node environment. And that's why we're so excited about this release, because you will have that ability. Now, I've been mentioning multi-node quite a bit. Again, some of you may be familiar with a multi-node environment, however, some may not be. So let's dig into that a bit. So a multi-node environment is essentially spreading out your data onto multiple Postgres instances, as opposed to just having one database or one Postgres instance, right? And how TimescaleDB does this specifically is that we partition your data across multiple databases, which we call our data nodes, with one main database at its command center, which we call the access node. And essentially, this access node is communicating with all of the data nodes so that you can query data and now have continuous aggregates in such a way that it acts exactly like a single database. Pretty sweet, right? Now, I'm the kind of person that loves a good example, so let's actually consider a scenario. Again, for those of you who may not be as familiar with the multi-node environment. Say that you have a bunch of IoT devices, and each of these IoT devices have a specific ID telling you exactly which device is recording what time series data. And say that these IoT devices are recording a lot of data. Now, this is exactly the kind of case where multi-node might be useful for the user. You see, multi-node is most useful for users that are querying and housing a lot of data. So in this scenario, that would fit the bill, you know? And in addition, not only do you need to have lots of data that you're storing, but you also need to not only have data that's partitioning by time, but also some other categorical variable. Right, and in this scenario, the other categorical variable would be these device IDs, okay? So in this scenario, let's say that the individual wanted to move forward with a multi-node environment, saw the benefits, maybe were hitting storage boundaries, and needed to really spread out their data to record more. So in this scenario, let's say that they had two data nodes acting in their multi-node environment. The first data node might contain readings, time series readings, that is, for device ID 1 and 2. And data node 2 might contain all the time readings for device IDs 3, 4, and maybe 5 if there are 5 device IDs. So you see, we're partitioning the data based upon this categorical variable. And that's really where multi-node is most powerful. Now, again, this is just an example. So there are many other use cases, and it gets much more complicated when you look into the beef of things. But this is really just a quick wrap-up of how you could think about multi-node. Now, multi-node, with this example, and as I mentioned a little bit ago, it's most useful when you have a lot of data, right? And the same thing is true with continuous aggregates. It's most useful when you need to access aggregates of a lot of data, right? So you can imagine how awesome and powerful it is when you can actually use these two things in conjunction with one another. And that's partially why we're so excited to be giving this functionality to you all, is that you can really access the power of aggregating and storing tons of data, which you may have not been able to do before. So, enough of me talking about it. Let's actually look at a demo, right? You can take my word for it, but let's actually see how we create and use these continuous aggregates in a multi-node environment. And spoiler alert, it is exactly the same as whenever you use a single database environment, and we actually created it that way, which is really awesome. But let's actually see it in action so that you can see it as well. So first off, I am going to attach my Docker image, which is how I set up my multi-node environment. And I'm attaching my access node. And of course, my database is called multi-node, you know, very original. And I wanted to show you the setup of my multi-node environment. So I'm using one of our APIs, TimescaleDB information.datanodes, to show you that I have a two-node environment with data node 1 and data node 2. So then I will create a table, and I'm going to call this table energy data with a time column, an energy column, and then an ID column. And so that ID column is actually going to be how I partition across my data nodes. So then I want to create my distributed hypertable. And you know, I do it on my energy data table, partitioning by time, and then ID, that being the categorical partition in addition to time. So then, of course, I want to run this command, and then I need to populate my table. So I am just going to use random data to populate my table, and you know, just general, some integers, you know, random numeric values, and time. And that's going to give me 17,000 rows of data. And just to show you kind of what this table looks like, right, the time is intervaling by 1 hour, so each hour, quote unquote, I'm getting an energy reading with some kind of ID. So we have hourly data here. So now I want to create my continuous aggregate. Since we have hourly data, right, I want to bucket it by day. I want to see how much energy, right, the sum of my energy over 1 day. So, right, that's where the sum energy comes in. And as you can see, this continuous aggregate is exactly the same as it would be if I were to create this in a single database, right? It's nothing is changed, which is awesome. So then, of course, in addition to my continuous aggregate, I also want to create a refresh policy. And so, you know, I use the add continuous aggregate policy
on my multi-node CAG continuous aggregate. I want to set the start offset, end offset, and then my schedule interval options according to, you know, however I want to set up this, you know, refresh policy. And then just to show you how much data is in each table, I have 17,000 in my original raw data table. And then in my continuous aggregate, I have 733 rows of data. So that's how it stands at the moment. So of course, now I want to create a retention policy, which can be, you know, very valuable if you need to remove data, if you're running out of space. So I'm doing the add retention policy, stating the table, and setting the interval. So I'm doing deleting anything before 12 months. And so I'm just going to show you, right, that my raw data table has a lot less data in it now. And I have 1,700 rows of data instead of 17,000. And my continuous aggregate is unchanged, right? This is exactly as we expected. It's the same behavior as in a single database environment. And just, you know, to show you, I'll even call a refresh continuous aggregate policy. Of course, it says my multi-node continuous aggregate is up to date. And so now I'll just add some new data to show kind of that functionality, how it's going to continually keep up with my newly inserted data. So I insert 300 rows, and now I'm going to count my raw data table, right? I increase by 300 rows, awesome. And my continuous aggregate has also increased, which is great. So again, this should act exactly as your continuous aggregate setup workflow should or does work in a single database environment, which is really, really cool.
Now, that continuous aggregate that I created in the demo is actually going to be housed in my access node, not my data nodes. And this will be true for all continuous aggregates created in a multi-node environment, at least at this time. Now, we are looking into allowing the distribution of continuous aggregates, but that is likely going to be future work, and we'll definitely keep you posted on when that's going to be available. So definitely keep your eyes and ears open for any developments in that realm. But in addition to this awesome multi-node functionality, we will also allow you to work with Postgres 14, which is very exciting. And we also updated some of the experimental time bucket ng functionality to allow you to use time zones and bucket by months and years, which is very exciting. Now, I would like to note that with all of our experimental functionality, this including time bucket ng, these are experimental, hence the name, right? So if you have any issues, questions, or feedback on how we can improve these features, definitely hit us up on GitHub or on Slack. We would love to hear from you and hear how we could improve. So definitely check out this functionality if you're using multi-node. Get excited and definitely try out continuous aggregates. We're really excited about this feature and being able to support it for all of you. Hope that you all have a wonderful rest of your day and happy coding. See you all later.